Looks like you ended up in Four Hearts by South, and West leads the small spade. So you could start by counting some tricks. You seem to have four club tricks and three heart tricks and two spade tricks. 4, 7, 9. You need one more trick somehow to make 10. That could be difficult, but first you have to decide which spade you want to win. It probably doesn't matter. Let's say you win the ace of spades, and your plan is to get some kids off the street, so you start with the king of hearts, and play another heart. You're hoping that one person has three hearts and the other one has two hearts, and Lady Luck was smiling on you. So there's one more heart out. Let's say that you decide to take out the last heart because you don't want the enemy to trump your good clubs. This is probably a mistake, because now he's going to lead another spade. And you can take all your four club tricks. But that's probably where where it hits the fan, because when you're missing ace, king of diamonds, you don't want to be leading diamonds yourself, because you're probably going to lose three diamonds. You lose the play the three. West plays low. You have to play your queen and loses to the king. Then West plays another diamond. You play your nine. You lose to the 10, and you also lose to the ace. So you've lost four tricks, and you only made nine tricks. So going back to the beginning, we need a better plan. You can win the first spade, doesn't matter which one, the ace or the king. Then you play two rounds of hearts. And eight hearts are gone. There's one more heart, but it's higher than yours. So you should probably never, ever take out the last trump when it's higher than yours, because you're wasting two of your trump to get one trump, which you're going to lose anyway. So another important technique is to get rid of all the suits, get rid of the spade, take the spades out so you don't have any more spades, then play all your clubs. And it doesn't matter if one of the opponents trumps your good club suit. He's going to win that trump anyway. Let's say he trumps your there. And if he leads a diamond, you're guaranteed to get a diamond trick. So this guy takes the king, but you don't have to waste your jack or your queen. So when he plays another diamond, he has to take the ace, and you end up with a diamond trick. So all they get is three tricks. But going back, let's say he trumps your last club, and he leads a spade instead. That's wonderful, because you can't lead a spade. you can't trump a spade because you can't lead a spade. But if the enemy leads a spade, you get to trump a spade in a dummy, and you get to throw a diamond loser away from your hand. It's called a rough and a slough. You rough in one hand, you slough in the other. It's the worst defensive play that the opponents can make. But we saw already, if they lead a diamond, you're guaranteed to get a diamond trick. So you make your 10 tricks no matter what. But let's go back. Let's go back a bit and say that he doesn't trump your last club trick, but he just throws a spade away. And you play your last club, and he just throws a spade away. So now you still don't want to play diamonds, and you've got two trump left in each hand, so you can afford to give the enemy his heart trick, because he can't do you any harm. The same thing will happen if he leads a spade. You'll trump it in a dummy, and you'll throw a diamond loser away, and you'll end up losing only two diamonds. But if he leads a diamond, the same thing will happen. If he leads a diamond, you play low. East has to take the king, and then one of your diamond honors will survive. If he leads a spade, you'll do the same thing. You'll trump in one hand and throw a diamond loser from the other. That's called a rough and a slough. And it's a wonderful play because it gives you a trick you could never get on your own steam. If he plays back the diamond, West has to take the ace, then you're guaranteed to get a diamond trick. And you make your 10 tricks that way too. So that was a neat hand. This is an extreme hand, but it shows you, you end up in six spades on this hand, and West leads a small diamond. And you remember the teacher said, get rid of all the suits that you can, all the side suits. So instead of taking the ace of diamonds right away, you trump the first diamond with, you're only missing two spades, so you could even trump with the ace of spades, but let's say we trump with the seven, and then you play the ace of spades, and East doesn't have any spades, so you play one more spade, ending in the dummy. So all the spades are gone, and you proceed to get rid of all the red suits, get rid of the ace of diamonds, you can throw a club away, and play the ace of hearts. And then the king of hearts, get rid of another club. Then play a heart and trumpet, whichever, with a spade. Then go back to the dummy with a spade. And trump the last heart. East has to keep his three clubs, and you trump the heart. And now you're ready to finesse the club. So you lead the 10 of clubs, and West didn't have any clubs. So you let East win his queen of clubs, but East can't do anything to harm you if he leads a small club. You can see your jack's going to win, and then you get the last two tricks. If he leads the king of clubs, you take the ace, then the jack and the is a winner, and the queen of spades is a winner. So what if he leads the king of diamonds? Well, that's even better, because now you got rid of all the diamonds and hearts, so you can trump with one hand and discard the jack of clubs from the other. You get a rough and a slough, so there's nothing East can do to harm you. But let's go back a bit. Before you got rid of all the hearts, let's say that you play the ace of hearts and the king of hearts, throwing a club away. Then you trump a heart to get to your hand. Let's say you finesse the club immediately before you got rid of the last heart. You finesse the club, losing to the queen. Now East can play a heart, and you have to trump that heart. And now you have no choice but to finesse the club a second time. And this time you lose to the king, so you go down one, only because you did not get rid of all the red cards right away. But this is a very difficult hand, and very few people will make six spades, because I've stacked this hand about a dozen times, and almost nobody will make six spades, because they won't start getting rid of the red suits immediately. You have to see that right at trick one, when a diamond is led. You have to immediately trump a diamond. Instead of playing your ace of diamonds, you start off by getting rid of the diamonds by trumping, and then take out two rounds of spades. You could play just one round of spades and trump. Oh, you would have to play an ace of hearts and trump a heart with the ace of spades, so nobody could trump higher than you in case West had a singleton heart. Then you can take out the last trump and start getting rid of the red suits again. So ace of diamonds, get rid of a club. A king of hearts, get rid of a club. Trump a heart. And this time you have two trump left in each hand. But it was only necessary to have one trump left in each hand, so that when you finesse the club, East has no choice but to lead another club or to lead a diamond. If he leads a club, that will be poison. He's going to die. If he leads a diamond, that's a different kind of poison, because you're going to trump in one hand and you're going to slough a loser from the other. You're going to get a rough and a slough, but only because you eliminated all the red suits before you made your club finesse. And that would be, that should be your strategy from the very beginning. You have to say, I might have to finesse clubs, but I'm going to leave it to the bitter end, the very, very end. And you still need to get the kids off the street at the same time that you're getting rid of the red suits from the dummy and your hand too. It's easy to get rid of the red suits from your hand, but not so easy to get rid of all those red cards from the dummy. You have to do that carefully and take the trump out at the same time. So that was a tricky hand for sure. Here's one more hand where you end up in six spades again, and West leads the ace of clubs. So you can trump the ace of clubs, and you're only missing two spades, so pretty soon you can eliminate the spades in one round. And what the opponent did, or what the first declarer did, was right away he finessed the heart, thinking, I only need one more trick to make 12, but he lost the heart trick, and West played back a diamond, whatever, took the high card from the shorthand, played another diamond to the long hand, and on the king of diamonds, discarded a heart. But that wasn't enough because he still had to lose another heart trick. He took his ace of hearts. Where are we? Diamond. So played his ace of hearts, and he gave up. He lost a heart. And he was down one, lost two tricks. Getting back to the beginning, West probably wouldn't lead the ace of clubs unless he has the king. Anyway, we'll soon find out which clubs he has. You want to get the trump out in one round. It's only going to take one round to take the trump out. And we already said it's a good idea to get rid of the red suits. So he played, and you want to get rid of the clubs too, at least some of them. But let's start with ace of diamonds and another diamond and another diamond. Now you got rid of all the diamonds. You can go back to the dummy with with the nine of spades, and you can trump the ten of clubs. You better trump with the king or the queen so you can go back to the dummy once more with another spade. Okay, it's got to play a club. So now you go back to the dummy with a jack of spades, and instead of finessing the heart, instead of playing the heart, you lead the queen of clubs and discard a heart from your hand. Then West has to win the king of clubs, and there's nothing he can do but lead a heart or a diamond. If he leads a heart, you get all the rest of the tricks. So that's called a free finesse. He gives you a free finesse. But if he leads a diamond, that's even better, because you get to trump the diamond in the dummy, and you get to throw a heart loser away from your hand. You end up with a rough and a sluff again. But the whole trick to these hands is getting rid of all the side suits, like get rid of the diamonds and get rid of the clubs, except for the queen of clubs, which you can let West win the queen of clubs. So usually if he leads the ace, he usually has the king, but not necessarily. You might want to trump high so that use your smaller spades to get to the dummy later on. You have to be careful. Sometimes you want to get to the dummy with the nine of spades, and then you should probably trump that club right away. I'll trump with a high spade, and then play the diamond to the ace. Play the diamond to the king, queen of diamonds, throw a heart away, and then a small spade over to the dummy, dummy's jack. Okay, you can still get back to the dummy to finesse the heart if you have to, but before you finesse the heart, you play your queen of clubs, and if east covers with the king, then you trump it and then go back to the dummy with a spade and finesse the heart. But if east plays low, that's a good time to just get rid of a heart and let west win his king of clubs. Now, it doesn't matter what he leads. It's all poison. If he leads a heart, he's dead. You win all the rest of the tricks. If he leads a diamond, you trump in the dummy and discard your heart loser from your hand. That's a rough and a slough. If he leads a club, it's the same poison. You trump in the dummy and you discard a heart for loser. So all this, you almost have to see this before you touch the first card. You have to have this all planned out ahead of time so that you know exactly what you're doing, hopefully. But unfortunately, it took me about 20, 26 years before I was able to play these hands, and I finally read every book I could read on playing bridge hands, and this hand happened to be in one of those bridge books, so I managed to know how to play it. Otherwise, I would have gone down like everybody else. So anyway, that's the end. This technique is called elimination and end play. You take the trump out, eliminate two or three suits, and then let the enemy win a trick, and he gets end played, so he has to give you all the rest of the tricks. So it's pretty neat, and it's a real fun thing to do if you ever master this technique. So I hope you do. I hope these lessons will make you a better bridge player.